Hey, what's going on, guys? Joe here, coming at you today from Town Hall 12, and today we're going to take a look at a bit of a base burning piece. I do apologize ahead of time, guys. If you are running this base, I'm just recording it, that way I can remember how I three-started, because I see it so much. I saw it like four times in one day the other day, and the final one I actually did three-star. Previous to that, it was like 99, 98, 95. So, like, each base design changes. The variant of it changes slightly each time. The strategy has to be adjusted on the fly each time. So there's no right or wrong way to do it. I'm sure many of you out there are probably using different armies anyways, but this is the army that I'm using. I'm using the Pekka Bobat, and I really love this base design for it, because in this scenario, we have all of the wizard towers down here at the bottom of the base. Now, sometimes you'll see one or two up in the north side, but for the most part, the point of this base, or what this base is telling us, is that it's a trap base. They want you to come in from the south side and try to take on the town hall and find giant bombs and your troops to walk on the outside flanks and go up into these different corridors and avoid the core of the base. That is the intent of this layout. Now, the best way to hit this base and actually three star or get a very solid two star is to come in through the north side. And in this situation, we do have one multi-target Inferno Tower that is beautiful. There is no wizard towers. This is great for a bat bomb. So I'm going to approach it from the north. I do it every single time the same exact way, unless there's some minor adjustments here. But I'm going to start out with a baby dragon over here on the eastern side, and I want to try to take care of some of these buildings, and then I'm going to basically queen walk the north. So we're going to start out with a balloon, we're going to start out with the archer queen and her healers, and then the baby dragon. And the baby dragon is going to take out a few collectors in the mines and the elixir pumps, and then also the builder's hut. And I want the queen to go towards the northern point. We're gonna go ahead and drop our freeze spell, rage spell, and six bat spells on that multi-target Inferno Tower, and you're gonna get to watch the magic, because we have nothing but point defenses. There's a few air defenses, but no wizard towers at all, and the sweepers are down by the town hall. So bats move out to the air defenses, they take out archer towers, they move into the cannons, and then they work their way around the line of defenses to the mortar, the cannon, down to the archer towers. They'll continue to the next group of archer towers. You see how they're completely unimpeded? They're gonna move into a mortar, and then I'm gonna drop a freeze spell and allow them to take out that final wizard tower. That's basically where they're going to stop, because the Inferno towers in the core are set to multi-target instead of single target. Now, the queen has worked her way around the north side, or the northern point. I did mistakenly use her ability by accident, trying to drop the Barbarian King. It happens, guys. I'm not perfect. Nobody's perfect. We do these mistakes. It happens every once in a while. So I dropped the Barbarian King over here on the western side, and his job is to try to take out these buildings right here and work down toward, through these collectors and storages. And then I'm going to bring the queen and the Grand Warden, the bowlers, the Pekkas, and the wall wreckers straight to the core. So the wall wrecker is going to move through these compartments and open up these compartments leading to the Eagle Artillery and the town hall. And so we're going to allow that queen to work. We're going to drop a few wizards back behind to take care of some of these buildings and try to direct the queen inside the base. I'm holding on to the Pekkas. I don't want to drop them just yet, because they will get distracted and they will not follow the wall wrecker. As you can see, they got a little confused there. And then we drop the bowlers and then the Grand Warden. Now, I want to point out something for you. If there are buildings over in this zone right here, like up, like maybe they'll say there was a building sitting here, or maybe a building where this little statue's sitting, your bowlers will walk. They will not continue to the core. If there's buildings where the queen is standing or down where the Barbarian King is standing, more than likely your bowlers will walk. So you got to make sure that all of this stuff is cleared out, and that way they will in fact follow the wall wrecker to the core. As the wall wrecker cracks in, you can drop a rage spell. I don't think I have a rage spell remaining. No, yeah, there is. There's a rage spell. I froze the town hall, and then I used the Grand Warden's ability. And once the Grand Warden's ability is used, you want to try to time that where the town hall falls and the troops are unaffected by the Giga Bomb. And I also have an Electro Dragon in the composition. Sometimes I'll use the Electro Dragon on the funneling process. In this situation here, I didn't need it until the end, and it's busy over there working on the Clan Castle troops in the Hound and the Balloon. Now, if there had been Valkyries in there or maybe a Witch, we would have possibly had a little bit more a little bit more trouble out of it than what we did on this one. We did have a Hound and a Balloon in the Clan Castle, or a couple of Balloons. But from here, as you can see, the Bowlers survived the Giga Bomb, the Pekkas have survived, and now they're moving through that trap location. They're taking out hidden Teslas. The Queen is down there as well. The healers have shifted over to our Pekkas and Bowlers, and they're going to basically finish up on these collectors and the final two buildings. There's a building here and here. So this is just one possible scenario on how you could address this base if you are using this army. Now, it's really up to you guys on how you attack and the bases you're seeing. I'm recording this one, so I remember this one particular base, and then if I start to see another base, I'll record that one as well. Hopefully you guys find some value in the content today, guys. This is me doing my best to help you suck less. Smash that like button, subscribe if you haven't done so already, and thanks for watching, guys.
For those of you that keep up with our channel, everyday posts and all that, and you saw today's video, a lot of you called it, and I was actually surprised. I went back and read the comments for today's video, and I was like, wow, like, they know us pretty well.